Hello everyone, in today's Roblox Studio tutorial, I'll be teaching you how to make a total stat system that, upon earning money, and then removing money, it will show you the total amount of money you have earned. As you can see, this will also work with many different values. For example, my gems are at 175, yet my total gem amount is at 400, because that's the total amount that I've gotten. This can work up to an infinite amount of values that you'd like. Now, without further ado, let's get right into the video. To your server script service and add again a script. Now, inside the script, what we can do is we're going to be creating a leader stats. If you don't already have leader stats, you can copy and paste down from the description below. Now, if you want multiple values, you can simply copy this bit of code right here and drop a few lines and paste it in. Next, we can rename this. I'll be naming this one to gems and rename this one to clicks. There we go. We now have our, what is this called? We now have our leader stats. Let's rename this to leader stats really quickly. There we go. Okay, once you have your leader stats, we're going to create a new script. This one is going to be called total stats. So total stats. And we can go into our leader stats. And we can simply copy this, close out that script, and paste it into here. Now, if you have a data store, you're going to want to change the name of the data store, such as that it won't get mixed up. Or actually, you don't have to. I'm not too sure. I'm not very good with data stores, although I doubt you'll have to change it, but change it just to be safe. Okay. So inside of here, instead of setting this as leader stats, we're going to call this total stats. And then what we can do is we can go total money, total gems, and total clicks. Once we have our total money, total gems, and total clicks, we can close out of that. Next, we have to create a GUI. Once we have our little GUI like I made right here, next we can do is we have to put in a few little bars. Now what we can do here is we're gonna add a text label, place one, duplicate one, place another one, and just duplicate them until you have however many stats you have that you want to save as total stats. Now I'm gonna do, there we go, that's a bit more accurate. So from here, let's rename this one to money, gems, and then lastly we have our clicks. And I spelled that really wrong. There we go, clicks. Now inside of here, I'm just going to go ahead and copy these. And do that. Whoops. I have to real quickly fix up this stroke, and I'll be done when I get everything, when I get all these buttons sorted out. And I have these buttons. Now inside of here, we can actually do is we're going to start doing a little code. I'm going to rename this code to getValue. There we go. So that's going to get our total value. Okay, so let's start off with typing local. Local PLR is equal to game.Players.LocalPlayer. Now, I know some people hate using variables, or some beginner coders might hate using variables, but variables are really useful, especially when you want to make quick edits to something. And they make your code a lot more neater and easier to follow around, especially when you're working on a game with more than one people. So please use variables, they're super useful. Anyways, let's keep on going. So next, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go local total stats. I can't spell stats. It's gonna be equal to PLR colon wait for child, and then we're gonna be waiting for our total stats. There we go. And local total stats. No, not total stats, but local. Let's go value is going to be equal to total stats dot colon wait for child. And then we're going to be getting our money in this one. So it's or total money. There we go. Now they have our total money. We can do is let's go in here. And let's also create one more variable, which is going to be local label is equal to script.parent. And then inside of here, we're just gonna go label.text is equal to, let's go money dot dot, or not money, but total money, colon dot dot. And then inside of here, we're gonna go value. Yes, I know this is a bit weird. Actually, you know, let's change this to total val, and we're gonna rename this to total. There you go, total val dot value. So when you join on, so the reason we have to do this is so when you join on in the game. Although this won't update, we could do a while true script, but that's gonna cause a bit of lag, especially in bigger games. So instead, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go total val colon get proper change signal. We're gonna be getting our value that's been changed. Then we're gonna go colon connect. We're gonna go connect function, and then we're just gonna do that. Now we just have to go and copy this in and paste this right here. Now let's add a quick note. What we're gonna do with this note is we're gonna say every time the value changes, every time the value changes, it will run this block of code. So every time the value changes, as you can see, this is sort of what's a block. So if we do that, or we press this button, it will hide what's ever inside of this block, or whatever you want to call this. I like calling these blocks. And this will be pretty much it. We just have to go copy, or actually we could just go close out of that, duplicate, place that in there, duplicate, and place that in there. Now we just have to change this. Instead of total money, let's go to total gems, and then inside of here we're gonna go total gems. So make sure this is the same as your value that you're getting. So whatever your, so inside of your leader stats, if we are getting, if you have gems, then you're gonna be getting your total gems, and you're gonna write that down right up here. So hope that's simple enough. Now I'm just gonna do that for the rest. As you can see, we haven't earned any money, so it's total money 0, total click 0, and total gem 0. Although now we have to do is we have to figure out a way to increase this value. And I'll see you right when I am finished building this GUI. My stats GUI is now finished. Now let's get into coding and seeing how you can actually earn stuff. Okay, so first let's insert a block. And inside of this block, let's go add in a local or just a regular script and a proximity prompt. Inside of here, what we're gonna have to do is let's go script.parent.proximity prompt dot triggered, and nope, not whatever I just did right there, connect function, and then we're gonna be PLR. Or actually, instead of PLR, or actually, you know what, let's just put, I'm gonna give you a little note. PLR is short for player. So pretty much PLR is short for player. I've been working on a game for a while now, and I've been using PLR because that's shorter. But usually in my tutorials, I like to use player. I just realized I made that mistake. So if you're being confused, PLR is just short for player. Okay? Okay, so next, what we have to do is we're just going to have to go in PLR.money. PLR.leaderstats.value plus equals, let's go with 100, and then PLR. Or not leader stats, but let's go money. Or this value, I'm just gonna do money is the currency that you earn. Okay, so money is the currency that you earn. And then we have to do PLR.total stats.total money. Total money dot value plus equals, and then 100. Another better way to do this is let's just go with local earn, and then we could do plus equal earn, There we go, because we're storing earn as an actual, or actually local earn is equal to 100. There we go. So earn is 100, so then we can just type earn for both of these instead of 100. So if we ever want to edit this value, you don't have to edit two, we just have to edit this variable. Okay, and let's just go duplicate that, and I'm going to create another note. There we go. Money, or actually total money, is the stat that increases. There we go. So this is what's going to increase. So now if we were to go in here and go up to this part, you should see we are getting 100, and if we go to our total stats, we also have 700. So it's going up just as fast. Although, if you're going to be taking away something, let's go inside of our script and change this. What we have to do is we actually just have to delete our total money and just put -1. And just like that, if we go close out of that. And then now if we go get earn some money, our total stats goes up. And then we take away some money, our total stats doesn't change at all. And you can do this for pretty much any stat you have right here. Anyways, thank you for watching. Hopefully you enjoy this tutorial. My next tutorial is going to be an upgrade of my previous backpack system, which is one of my most popular videos on this channel. And this user mentioned that I should recreate it and show people how to create a stat system. So I'll be doing that because that video is a bit old. And that one, that bag, you actually can't save, which I know a lot of people complained about. So I'll be making a better version and a much more simpler version, which will be better and will be savable. Yes. Anyways, if you have any suggestions for some YouTube videos, comment that down in the section below. No, comment in the comment section below. And make sure to subscribe. We're almost at 100 subscribers. Anyways, thank you so much for watching this video. Hopefully this helped. So, yeah. See you in the next one. Bye.